day, ladies and gentlemen. We are both delighted and privileged to have all of you here today, especially a couple of our luminaries who are here to grace the occasion. The first one to whom we would like to express our sincere gratitude is to the leading luminary of the cinema industry, Ms. Sonam Kapoor. Sonam, thank you very much for being here today. As always, we find you very, very cooperative, always finding the time for this cause and supporting us from the bottom of your heart. Our heartfelt thanks also to Mr. Mahesh Krishnamurthy, who was our first founding member of the fight. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Kakkar. I now request Arish Saeed, who is our executive director, to please come and address.
Thank you very much, sir. Now, first of all, because we have already spoken what Fight Hunger does, so I'm here to tell you where the action lies. Now, taking a clue from there, we have already signed MOUs with government, government departments, the health mission in the state of Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and Maharashtra. So having said this, if I would say these states are in the red corridors of highly focused undernutritional and undernourishment cases in the areas, and they're all in red in the range of from 8% to 20 percentage points. And that is where the action lies. Having signed the MOUs, we work on cross-thematic issues. And like we said, undernourishment cannot be just addressed by providing nutrition.
I invite you to carry on.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. So, So I'm here as a representative of ACF. ACF stands for Action Against Hunger in French. It's an international organization that has established operations across 47 countries worldwide. And in 2015, we are proud to say that we have been able to reach 15 million people through our programs. We have a strong ambition, which is to scale up the treatment of severe acute malnutrition. The question is, how can we do that? We have developed a strategy for 2016-2020 by which we want to reach 70% of SAM children worldwide to have access to a treatment, so then by 2020. And we've called this strategy SAM 2020, No Wasted Lives. If we look at the trends, the number of children who are severely malnourished is today at around 16 million worldwide. The number of children who have access to the treatment is only 3.2 million. There's a slight increase that we have been observing over the last 5 years, but it's far not enough. And our objective is to move ahead. Only 20
human level. Fight Hunger Foundation came to me a couple of months back and showed me photographs and told me all these statistics and spoke to me about this disease that the youth of our country is suffering. It's a whole generation. It's a generational problem, you know. And it was frankly, very, very scary. I thought, okay, you know, I want to dedicate some of my time to helping or giving back to society in some way. And I was like, how am I supposed to do that? I thought, let's talk about literacy. Let's think about building roads. Let's think about building toilets. You know, Rakesh Mehra was doing something with toilets, somebody was building some roads, someone was talking about, you know, many, many different issues. And, you know, I speak about feminism and health issues and body image issues. And these are all issues that can, they're generational issues, but something basic like food, shelter, clothing is something that you don't think about, especially when you come from such an affluent background like I do. I've been given everything in life. So when I saw some of these images, I felt like, I don't know, I understood what Gautam Buddha was going through, I think, to a certain extent. And I couldn't understand why this was happening. And I was trying to find a solution, and they came to me with a solution. And I was like, okay, is if I become a part of this organization, will it help? If I become a Goodwill ambassador, will it help? And they said, yeah. And I went to Zion Hospital because I wanted to see for myself, you know, because sometimes when you see photographs and you see, you become desensitized to it. So I went to the hospital and I was very, very, very moved to see parents of young girls, baby girls, who are not even barely 3 months old, 4 months old, fighting for the life of their child. They have no money, nothing. And I was like, there's so much wastage that happens. You know, I don't want to have food. And I'm like, okay, fine, meko nahi chahiye, khana nahi chahiye, aur mujhe ye nahi chahiye. And I felt so, I don't know what to say. It's, I felt very small. And I'm trying my very best by supporting this foundation to give back, because I've been given so much, and we've all been given so much. So I'm not going to tell you the statistics. I'm not going to tell you what everybody else is telling you. I'm just going to ask you to see beyond our small little lives. You know, we watch TV every day. We're talking about a lot of controversies. I say a lot of stupid things a lot of the times. But these issues are issues that actually, this is a very basic need that a lot of people, look at the numbers. There are 6 million children who are malnourished, and there are 1 million dying every day. It's appalling. It's an appalling number for a country like India, and it's an appalling number for a country that wastes so much food. There's so much wastage that happens. So, you know, I think it's time we give back, and I think the support of the media is very, very, very important. And that's why I'm here. I usually make very good copy. People like putting me on in your papers and magazines. So instead of my dresses and sometimes my movies, I think it'll be nice if you guys put this cause in your papers and write about it and put a picture of me with all these amazing people, with the Fight Hunger Foundation behind me. And your support and help will be amazing. Tweet about it, put it on social media. You know, donate is 5,000 rupees. It's not much at all. So I think that's basically what I wanted to say. I have like 2 pages of what I wanted to say, but I felt like everybody said so much. I just thought it was better to appeal to everybody on a human level. I'm very, very proud to be a Goodwill Ambassador for Fight Hunger Foundation. I've spoken about LGBT rights, you know, feminism, body image issues, cancer awareness, everything. These are all amazing causes, and they are getting a lot of, you know, a lot of awareness, and they make very, very good copy. But talking about malnourishment, I don't know, maybe is not as, I don't know, it's maybe it doesn't make that great copy. So it's an appeal to say that make it good copy, cover this way more, and spread awareness. That's why I'm here, and I think that's my duty as a Goodwill Ambassador, to appeal to y'all to write about it and speak about it and support it. Thank you so very much for being here and being patient through this whole thing and covering this program. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sona. In case anyone has any questions, we can take 1 or 2 questions. Yes, please. Can someone get her a mic?
Congratulations for being a Goodwill Ambassador. I was just going through the reports, then I get to know that malnutrition during pregnancy causes the child to have increased risk of future diseases. So we just go through all the figures and all the statistics. Being a Bollywood celebrity, I have seen films. We hardly go through with films जो ऐसे causes को promote करते हैं. तो क्या आप ऐसे causes को promote करते हुए कोई film बनाना चाहेंगी? क्योंकि आपने
बनाई है actually. Ek film, I think there is a video, right? You guys have made. Yeah. I think it'll be. Yeah. I don't know, like, if it's going to be shown now.
Because jo women hai, Sonam, wo, because of lack of knowledge, they don't get into all this. They don't
awareness
know.
Awareness is very, very important. Awareness is so, very important.
And hamari Indian audience film ko dekhkar.
Ma'am, I think you've asked your question. We'll just ask her to
that's
answer.
That's what I want to ask. That.
Yes. Yeah, thanks.
Would you like
no,
to
of
make
course,
films?
You know, there are so many. Cinema is a very, very, any art is a very great platform to inspire people to do better. But like when you see the statistics in our country and when you see the sadness and sometimes the poverty and stuff, people go to the, if they spend 200 rupees or 250 rupees or 50 rupees in smaller towns or 100 rupees in smaller towns, and villages and stuff like that, they want to go see color and entertainment and fun and songs and dance because they want to forget about their daily grief, you know. It was a very big, my sister was studying in New York University and they were talking about why Indian cinema is so colorful and why there's so much music and why there's so much dance. But I can also talk about two of my films that did very, very well. One was Prem Ratan Dhan Payo and the other one was Nija. They're both very, very different films and they both released 2 months within each other. And both of them did equally well. I'm not talking about numbers, I'm talking about, you know, the way they did talking about profit. And so it's not like India doesn't want one kind of film or not another kind of film. Anything that is an honest portrayal of what true India is or true Indian people are is what India wants to see. And so I can't answer that question because I just did Prem Ratan and Nija and they were both very, very different films. So I can't be like, oh, this, we can do this, but I think the country also needs a film like a Prem Ratan or a Sultan or, but they also need films like Anija, which is, they have no songs and no dance, but it speaks about the best, being the best version of yourself. I don't know, but I hope that certain causes are underlined, maybe on a subliminal level or a more obvious level. Let's see. Yeah, of course, I'm trying my very best. I haven't signed anything yet, but I'm trying.
Maharashtra, Rajasthan, and Madhya Pradesh. So why these three reasons? There are many reasons in India, like Northeast, Odisha, Jharkhand, jahan ki population zyadatar bahut hi poverty level se guzarti hai. To wahan par aap kyun nahi kaam kar rahe?
Jo Hindustan ke sabse kharab states hain in terms of malnutrition, two out of those are Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Maharashtra is a little better on that scenario, of course. Bihar, Uttarakhand. There are some states in the north which are equally bad, let's say. But, one of the things that we decided to do was to work alongside with the government, not against the government, not independent of the government, and so on and so forth. So we said, jahan jahan pe sarkar hamari madad karegi, jahan jahan hum sarkar ki madad kar sakte hain, collaborative relationship ho sakta hai, तो जिन जिन स्टेट्स ने हमारे साथ MOU साइन किए तो ऑल दीज थ्री स्टेट्स हैव साइंड एन MOU विद अस वेयर वी वर्क अलोंग विद द आंगनवाड़ी वर्कर्स वी वर्क अलोंग साइड द आशा वर्कर्स एंड सो ऑन एंड सो फोर्थ एंड मेक श्योर दैट द इम्पैक्ट इज द मैक्सिमम एंड द लार्जेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम कैन बी रिजॉल्व सो दैट इज पार्ट ऑफ द रीजन वाई वी स्टार्टेड विद दीज थ्री स्टेट्स एंड वी आर वेरी हैप्पी टू से दैट द इम्पैक्ट हैज बीन ट्रूली ट्रिमेंडस by working with these states.
Yani dusre jo states hai iska matlab ye hai ki those people jo government authorities hai they are not attentive to this cause.
Nahi aisa nahi hai, dekhiye kuch 8-10 saal pehle tak, you know, the whole attitude was of the central government and the state governments was there is no problem in India, you know, this is not an Indian problem because it is a political hot potato, hai na. So people used to say nahi nahi nahi, but jaise jaise individual incidents aate gaye, you know, like the media brought up this whole issue of Palghar now, You know, so similarly in various states, Rajasthan Patrika ne kuch nikale, Madhya Pradesh mein hua, Dainik Bhaskar ne kuch nikala, and so on and so forth. So as the issues came more and more to light, the government said, oh my God, we really need to do something about it. And some governments obviously had an easier time to do it. Some governments find it more difficult. Funds, there are so many issues involved in this. And we bring our own funds, we raise our own funds. For example, this evening, we are having a fundraising program where we will be raising funds for this. So it is a collaborative effort. So jahan jahan collaboration maximum mila, wahan humne teen states mein start kar diya, of which two are the worst affected states. Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh are amongst the five most affected states.
Chaliye, political interference ki baat to alag hogi. Ek hota hai private organizations ki baat hoti hai. Jaise ki aap collective work karte hain Anganwadi, is tarah ke organizations ke saath. To un states mein is tarah ke organizations aage aa rahe hain aapke saath?
Dekhiye, ye jo do teen states mein humne example khade kiye hain, उससे क्या हो रहा है कि दूसरे स्टेट्स उनको भी थोड़ी सी यू नो इंस्पिरेशन मिल रही है. तो वो लोग कह रहे हैं कि अरे अगर मध्य प्रदेश में ऐसा काम हो सकता है तो हमारे यहाँ क्यों नहीं हो सकता. अगर वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के फंड्स वहाँ पे जा रहे हैं तो हमारे पास क्यों नहीं आ सकते. हाँ, सो धीरे धीरे एक तो अवेयरनेस बढ़ रही है प्रॉब्लम की, दूसरा द विलिंगनेस टू डू समथिंग इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीजिंग विद द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स, विद द ब्यूरोक्रेसी, विद द पीपल एट लार्ज. And the media is the one that जो इस पूरे issue को जागरूक कर रहा है. So I think overall it's a good situation and hopefully we can light this fire across the country, you know, and eventually get to a goal where by 2030 our country is free of hunger and malnutrition. You know, that is the overall goal. अब कर पाएंगे नहीं कर पाएंगे, कोशिश तो 2030 तक हमें इस problem को eliminate. देखिए polio को हमने बहुत अच्छी तरह eradicate किया है और ये भी इराडिकेट, फुल्ली इराडिकेट हो सकती है और उसी से हमको बहुत आशा मिलती है, हमें बहुत उत्साह मिलता है. तो दैट्स व्हाट वी आर टॉकिंग.
सोनम, आपसे सवाल है कि कितना एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा आपका ओवरऑल, और इस कॉज से जुड़ने के लिए आपको बधाई, लेकिन आप कितना खुद जुड़ी और कितने लोगों को बॉलीवुड में आपने जुड़ने के लिए कहा जो आपके फ्रेंड्स हैं?
ऑनेस्टली अगर आप मैं वेरी आई एम हियर विद फाइट हंगर फाउंडेशन, मैं बहुत आई थिंक कम महीनों के साथ इनके साथ जुड़ी हुई हूँ. मेरी पूरी कोशिश जारी रही है इनके साथ काम करने में, उनके साथ वीडियोज़ बनाने में. हॉस्पिटल में साइन हॉस्पिटल, लाइक शी सेड देयर आर ओनली 20 बेड्स, पर मैंने वहाँ जाके देखा कि वो एक स्पेशल फार्मूला बनाते हैं फॉर मैल नरिश चिल्ड्रन. तो वो फार्मूला कैसे बनाते हैं एंड वाई दिस फार्मूला इज़ नीडेड, बिकॉज मैनी मैल नरिश चिल्ड्रन के नॉट eat food. जो खाना हम सब खाते हैं ना, even like a khichdi or anything, they can't digest it because their body is not used to digesting this food. तो ये सब समझने में time लगता है. You know, it's very scientific. There's a lot of research that these people have done, a lot of statistics. तो ये सब मुझे समझना था जुड़ने के बाद, जुड़ने के पहले, कि मैं अगर मैं इस cause के साथ जुड़ूंगी तो क्या क्या मुझे करना पड़ेगा. तो ये सब मैंने देखा. तो नाउ इट्स नाउ अप टू मी टू काइंड ऑफ विथ, ऑब्वियसली दे हैव एन इनक्रेडिबल टीम ऑफ डॉक्टर्स, न्यूट्रिशनिस्ट, अ लॉट ऑफ साइंटिस्ट, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम द कॉर्पोरेट वर्ल्ड दैट आर यू नो इन्वेस्टिंग अ लॉट ऑफ मनी. दैट होल टीम इज अमेजिंग. इवन सो आई थिंक इट्स जस्ट अ मैटर ऑफ गोइंग फॉरवर्ड एंड गोइंग अहेड एंड स्प्रेडिंग अवेयरनेस. एंड मैं I mean, I'm trying my very best by doing this, by going in the evening and being a part of the fundraiser, by visiting hospitals, by creating awareness, giving a little money. I'm doing whatever I can. So let's see what happens. But jaise unhone kaha ki hamari aasha yahi hai ki time aur waqt ke saath things improve. And you know, we see, because eventually this is the future of our country. You know, it's a generational problem. These are young people, these are young children, these are babies who are the future. I'm 30 years old, so it's a matter of taking care of your generation, you know, that's basically what it is. It's just to create awareness and try to help as much as I can.
सुनम, जब भी आपका नाम आता है, एक फाइटर की तरह आता है, ऑनेस्ट आप रहती हैं, कभी भी बॉलीवुड में कोई भी चीज़ बोलने के लिए आप नहीं रहती, लेकिन जिसके बाद आपको भी कमेंट्स मिलता है, तो आप किस तरह से डील करती है? हर्षवर्धन में भी यही क्वालिटी देखी गई है, सभी कहते हैं कि आप जो
आपको लगता है कि ये करेक्ट प्लेटफॉर्म है इसके बारे में पूछने के लिए, अगर आपको लगता है कि करेक्ट प्लेटफॉर्म है तो मैं ये क्वेश्चन आंसर करूँगी, आप प्लीज़ मुझे बताइए. Because I'm very, very happy to answer all questions related to this cause and on this platform right now. Because we've actually given a lot of time and effort to explain to you why this is a very worthy cause for you guys to write about.
Hi, Sonam, Ravi Kumar, News Helpline.
Namaste.
इन्होंने पोलियो का एक एग्जांपल लिया था. बच्चन साहब ने दो बूंद जिंदगी का एक डायलॉग उन्होंने बोला था और काफी फेमस हो गया था. और जिसने हेल्प भी किया था इरेडिकेट करने के लिए पूरा पोलियो का जो प्रॉब्लम है, तो आपको लगता है एक डायलॉग जनरेट करने की बहुत सख्त ज़रूरत है इस कॉज को प्रमोट करने के लिए और इस प्रॉब्लम को इरेडिकेट करने के लिए?
मैं प्रसून सर को फ़ोन करती हूँ, मैं पूछती हूँ अगर वो एक कविता या कोई लाइंस हमारे लिए लिखेंगे. देखते हैं, उन्होंने मुझे बहुत अच्छी अच्छी लाइंस दी हैं, हम ट्राई करते हैं, क्यों नहीं.
My question is to Mr. Kakkar. Sir, I'd like to know, are you trying to tie up with other governments as well, other than these three? After...
Equivocal, yes. In fact, we have dialogues going on with at least two or three governments, which include Uttarakhand, which include Bihar, which include some of the other states, especially in the north. There are parts of UP, but we haven't been able to have a dialogue with the government in UP yet, and we would like to do that as well. But more importantly, increasing awareness also with the central government. We are in discussions also with the Niti Aayog to say that, you know, long term, aap kaise is problem ko hamara 2030 ke goal ko kaise aap support kar sakte hain. So, and it is across all party lines, it is across all governments. It is across, it, because we are not in any way, politically aligned, or we have no such agenda at all. We just have a humanitarian agenda, and that is number one, number two, and number 100. You know, so that is the only thing, and we want to see an India which is absolutely hunger-free, malnutrition-free.
And also, are you trying to tie up with private hospitals like Fortis and Medanta? So they will be of good help.
So, you know, the first step is to actually go into the village health centers. So that is where we have started. So the first step is going into all the local village health centers, block health centers, district health centers, those kind of places, and we are physically training the Anganwadi workers, the Asha workers, we are training the nurses, and sometimes even supporting the doctors as they want more and more of this material which is peanut based or other based and so on. So one set of things relates to how we can train, how we can access the lowest level where it's furthest from the center, no? And then as we come closer, and as we get closer, now for example, Mumbai, Dharavi, we are working in the slums, we are working in Govandi, and so on and so forth. Thane, Kalbe, we have not yet touched on those, but step by step, we are going into various areas. And I think training is one part. The other part is creating the material, you know. So along with Sion Hospital, we work to create a peanut paste, because peanut is the cheapest and the densest material which can actually save lives. And equally with the Ministry of Biotechnology in Delhi, we are working on a soya-based product. So where peanuts are not there, soya may be quite helpful because it's also low cost. So in order to, then we are doing some competitions for machinery. Then we are doing some technological, we are building an app. See, up to now, you have to measure the circumference of the arm and the length of this bone to derive the ratio which defines malnutrition, okay? But now we are, along with Instagram, we are trying to build an app which you take a photograph and the photograph will automatically calculate the ratio, will automatically log it into the computer and collect the data from that district, from that block, from that village and so on and so forth. And you can identify malnutrition. So there's a lot of work that's going on, but it's very scientific, very structured, and good work along many lines.
why we
we'll just take this as
out,
a last question, yeah. please. Thank you.
So why we pointed out about your partnerships with, you know, private sector players Ji. Is because since you, you know, brought up the issue of urban malnutrition, which Ji. Is very evident in Mumbai.
Ji.
So hospitals from Mumbai itself, yeah. like an Hinduja or a Apollo coming up, they can provide you infrastructure that you require.
That's right. So what we are doing in Mumbai is, for example, Sion Hospital has already about 20 beds. It used to be 16. We have helped in raising it to 20 beds already. Now, there are also child hospitals like Wadia Hospital. So we are working along with Wadia Hospital now. So one step at a time. I think, as you get to the upper end of the pyramid, there are fewer and fewer people who are affected by malnutrition. The maximum part of the problem is at the bottom of the pyramid. So we are trying to address the largest part of the problem by going to the lowest part of the pyramid and trying to resolve it. Yeah?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Heartfelt gratitude to Sonam. Thank you so much for sparing the time. It has meant a lot to us to have your support. Thank you so much, Mr. Mahesh Krishnamurthy, and we look forward to your continued support. Thank you so much to each of you for having come here. We request you to please join us for some tea. And we're also very happy to announce that the famous playback singer Sonu Nigam has sung a song for us, so I'm going to play that as you enjoy your tea. Thank you so much once again.
For more news and gossip, don't forget to subscribe to Bollywood Helpline.